Several days ago, we posted a video of the first DJI 100 watts dual USB-C charger. Many of you guys were requesting the teardown of other high-power dual USB-C chargers. Today, we got a 65 watts dual USB-C charger from a well-known brand, Belkin. Let's go ahead and take it apart to see its internal structure and components. The packaging continues Belkin's design with the critical features at the bottom. Since it's equipped with two USB-C ports, you can fast charge your laptop and phone at the same time. Open the box. The charger itself and tons of documents are inside the box. Tear off the plastic film. It's like a short column with rounded edges. All specs info are printed on one side, whitelist WCH013YZ. It can support input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60 Hz, 1.5 amp. The single output can be up to 65 watts, and the dual output can be up to 20 watts and 45 watts. It also supports PBS to fast charge your Android phones. The input prongs can be folded, which is convenient to carry around. Those two USB-C ports are placed side by side, with output power printed next to them. The size of the charger is about 52 by 39 by 40.5mm. Compared with Apple's 61 watts charger, it's much smaller but has an additional port. And the weight is about 106 grams. Connected to Georgia Power ZKM00-C, it shows the USB-C 1 supports PD3.0, PPS, and QC5 protocols. And it also has 5 fixed speeds of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 3.25A, and a set of PPS. Move to the USB-C 2, the supported protocols and PDOs are exactly the same as USB-C 1, so you don't need to tell which is faster. Next, we will take it apart to see its internal components. Pry along the button case. We can see that the black and red wires are connected to the input prongs. And continue to use the cutting machine to cut off the plastic case. Then we can take out the PCBA module easily. There are some graphite thermal sheet and heat-resistant tape inside the case. The internal module is pretty compact and consists of 4 small PCBs. ChargeLab found it adopts high-frequency QR flatback topology and the power supply solution is from Southchip. The SMD input fuse is from Better Electronics, specs is 3.15 amp. The safety extra capacitor is from Weiqing Electronics, 0.33 microfarad. Those two common mode chokes are wound with magnet wires and insulated wires. The NTC thermistor is insulated with a heat shrinkable tube. The bridge rectifier is marked with DBF806, 8A, 600 volts. The electrolytic capacitor for input filtering is from SG Gather, 39 microfarad, 400 volts. And SMDY capacitor is from TRX. The differential mode choke adopts an I-shaped magnetic core and is insulated by heat shrinkable tube. There were two other electrolytic capacitors on a small PCB from SG Gather, both of them are 33 microfarad, 400 volts. The mass control chip is from Southchip, which integrates the GAN driver to drive the GAN IC. And the GAN IC is from Navitas and adopts a QFN6x8 package. It has a high integration to make the charger smaller, 170 milliohm, 700 volts. Here is the transformer, tightly wound and insulated with tape. The optocoupler is used for output voltage feedback. The synchronous rectification controller is from Southchip, which does not need an auxiliary coil. It can also support adaptive turn-on detection and fast turn-off. The synchronous rectifier is from TechCode and adopts DFN 5x6 package. The protocol chip of USB-C 1 is from Southchip and adopts 16-pin QFN 4x4 package. It also has USB IF PD 3.0 certification. Another protocol chip on the front is also from SouthChip, but in a different model. It's used to control the output of USB-C 1 and USB-C 2. There are two identical synchronous buck circuits. The synchronous buck controller is from TechCold and can support with standard voltage of 40 volts. The synchronous buck MOSFET is also from TechCold, 30 volts, 5 milliohm. Another same synchronous buck MOSFET is on the back to form a half bridge. Two buck inductors are insulated with heat shrinkable tubes. The solid capacitor for output filtering is from APAQ, 220 microfarad, 25 volts. The output VBUS MOSFET is from AGM Semi and adopts DFN 3x3 package, 30 volts, 5.8 milliohm. Well, that's all components of the Belkin 65W dual USB-C charger. Compared with ordinary single-port 65W chargers, the extra USB-C port allows you to charge your laptop and mobile phone at the same time. And after taking apart, we found it consists of four small PCBs. The internal gaps are filled with silicon adhesives to make it more solid. Besides that, two independent synchronous buck circuits can avoid telling which port is faster, bringing you a better experience. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye!